This is the third video in linear algebra for machine learning series. Last time, we saw vectors from a geometric perspective, how they can be stretched, shrinked, flipped, or rotated. In this video, we will build some intuition about vector projections, dot products, and orthogonalization. We learned to represent vectors as an arrow with the tail at the origin and the head at the value of the vector. The dot product is one way of multiplying two or more vectors. Algebraically, the dot product is the sum of the products of the corresponding entries of the two sequences of numbers. If we have two vectors A and B with coordinates 3, 1 and 1, 3, then the dot product can be given by multiplying the first element of A with the first element of B and the second element of A with the second element of B. The dot product in this case is 6. Notice that the resultant of the dot product of vectors is a scalar quantity. Thus, the dot product is also known as scalar product. Geometrically, it is the product of the Euclidean magnitudes of the two vectors and the cosine of the angle between them. Both these definitions are equivalent when using Cartesian coordinates. You need to understand projection of a vector before we discuss more about the dot products. The vector projection of one vector over another vector can be assumed as the length of the shadow of the given vector over the another vector. Let's talk about a few geometric interpretations that we can make here. We have OA and OB, two vectors. Let theta be the angle between them. If you draw BL perpendicular to OA, that is to the tip of the projection of the vector B on A. From the right angle triangle OLB, cos theta is equals the length OL divided by OB. It can be rewritten as OL equals OB cos theta, that is magnitude of vector B times cos theta. Okay, to multiply two vectors, it makes sense to multiply their lengths together, but only when they point in the same direction, right? So A dot B can be written as magnitude of A times length of OL, and now it should be clear after substituting OL equals B cos theta why the dot product is given by AB cos theta. Also, OL is the vector projection of A on B. So the same equation can be written as A times projection of B on A. It should be intuitive that you can also find the angle between A and B and also the length of the projection if you have the vector coordinates. The cosine of the angle between two vectors is equal to the sum of the product of the individual constituents of the vector. That is the dot product of the two vectors divided by the product of the magnitude of the two vectors. So we just saw that the dot product is obtained by multiplying the magnitude of the given vectors with the cosecant of the angle between the two vectors, and the resultant is a scalar value. The dot product is also useful for finding the component of one vector in the direction of the other. One important property of dot products is that it is commutative. Let's see if B dot A gives us the same result as A dot B did. This time we will project A onto B. We get magnitude of B times magnitude of A times the cosecant of the angle between A and B, which is essentially same as what we got for A dot B. Also notice that even if we scale any of these vectors, the dot product would be a scalar multiple of that scale factor. The unit vectors along x and y axes are 0, 1 and 1, 0 for the horizontal and the vertical axis respectively. Their dot product is 0, that is A dot B equals 0. No wonder, right? Because the two axes are perpendicular to each other and cos 90 equals 0. So that validates our result. Let's see what happens if we compute the dot product of a vector with itself. Can you guess? Since the angle between a vector and itself is 0 and cos 0 equals 1, The dot product of a vector with itself is similar to finding the square of its magnitude. You will see this alternative way of arriving at vector magnitude in a number of places in machine learning literature. Let's see a few more examples to understand how the angle between two vectors relates to their dot products. The angle value varies between 0 and 180 degrees. There are three important observations here. The dot product of two vectors is positive when the angle between them is less than 90 degrees. Negative when the angle between them is more than 90 degrees. And zero when the angle between them is exactly 90 degrees. Let's see a few more examples where we project A onto B now. These are the same vectors we just saw, so you can visit back and verify that for the same set of vectors, the resultant dot product is same, which should also be clear from the fact that the dot product is commutative. Now that you know dot product and angle between vectors, it is time to learn about the orthogonality of vectors. We saw in the earlier example that the dot product of two vectors is 0 if the angle between them is 90 degrees, since cos 90 equals 0. Such non-zero vectors with a 0 dot product are said to be mutually orthogonal. Also, if two orthogonal vectors are also unit vectors, then they are said to be orthonormal. An understanding of orthogonal and orthonormal vectors is important for machine learning applications. If a set of vectors is the basis for a space and they are also orthonormal, then they are known as orthonormal basis of that space. Note that x-axis and y-axis are orthonormal basis of a Cartesian coordinate system. And any point on that space can be defined in terms of their x and y coordinates. We saw this in our last video. Data or models seldom automatically lead to orthogonal vectors, but many applications such as machine learning benefit from the representation of the data along orthonormal basis. For such application of linear algebra, it is a common practice to discover the orthonormal basis for any given set of vectors. Orthogonalization is the process used to arrive at orthogonal vectors from any given set of vectors. The popular algorithm used for this approach is known as the Gram-Schmidt approach, as it is numerically more stable than others. That is, it introduces less errors due to the finite precision arithmetic. Or you can say that it is less sensitive to the round-off errors. Here is how the Gram-Schmidt approach for orthogonalization works. First, we compute the projection of the vector B onto A. Intuitively, this is a portion of B in the direction of A. Now, we need to just figure out the portion of B that cannot be explained by the projection of B onto A. Remaining means subtraction, and that's what we do. So, this orange vector is the component of B that is orthogonal to A. Thus, intuitively, it can be seen that B can be split into two components. One that is along the same direction as A, and the remaining which is orthogonal to that direction. We will see the applications of these concepts in machine learning in later videos, since it would be a little more information at this point. But stay tuned, We'll make it there soon. Thanks for your time. Have a nice day.